Ever felt blockchain development was too tough, with no clear starting point and just getting harder as you move forward? Hi, I'm Fifo, and today we're exploring Stellar Plus, an open source library designed to making developing on the Stellar network straightforward. A common challenge for new developers coming into the blockchain space is the learning curve. It's not only a new set of tools they're interacting with, but a whole different way of thinking when building applications. As a principal blockchain engineer at Cheesecake Labs, I often guide engineers through this initial hurdle, helping them throughout the journey of getting to know the environment, how transactions work, and delve deeper into this technology. It takes some time to start seeing the results, and the learning curve can be discouraging, especially as the challenges become more and more complex and solutions scale up. That's why we created Stellar Plus. It's a JavaScript library built by Cheesecake Labs. It is designed to simplify application development on the Stellar network. It combines existing tools and best practices from the ecosystem into a streamlined, efficient toolkit for developers. As of right now, at the recording of this video, it is in beta release and fully open source. Alright, Fifo, but what's inside Stellar Plus? For these initial releases, we are focusing on some core functionalities, often present in many different use cases. As we move forward in this video series, I'll be diving deep into each and every one of these features and explaining with examples and tutorials, but for now let me give you a sense of what we're talking about. For account handling, we abstracted the way keys are handled by the application, so you can manage and create new accounts on the fly. You can also follow different methods for signing and authorizing transactions or easily connect with Freighter Wallet in a front-end application. These handlers integrate with other features and ensure accounts and keys are accessed at the right time throughout the different workflows in the library. And when you need something unique or personalized, like connecting to your key management system, you can easily expand upon these tools and make your own account handler. Also core to the Stellar network is asset issuance. And for that, we currently have a few easy-to-use asset tools focusing on the main types of assets. We have a classic asset handler, meant for assets that are created and managed entirely with native Stellar operations. It combines the key functionalities to both manage the asset as an asset issuer or simply interact with it as an account that holds some balance and wants to transact. Similarly, we have a Soroban token handler, which is meant for assets that are created entirely through smart contracts as long as they follow the standard token implementation. It provides the same set of functionalities as the classic assets, but automatically handles the differences between both assets and carries the heavy load. Also, we have a very unique class of hybrid assets that have their own handler. These are classic assets that have been wrapped in what is called the Stellar Asset Contract, which allows these assets to interact with both native operations and smart contract operations. These are the bridge between classic Stellar transactions and the new features developed on Soroban. Speaking of Soroban, as we move forward, we get into the core engines within Stellar Plus, which is a set of more advanced functionalities meant for developers who really want to build unique and robust use cases. These features are implemented within the ready-to-use tools and can be leveraged to develop your own solutions with ease. The first one is called Contract Engine, and on itself, it's just like a powerful engine for a vehicle. It can be used for different kinds of vehicles, but you'll need to build around it to make it a truck or a car or a bike. The contract engine bundles the core features and workflows that any smart contract application would need to be used with Soroban. With very minimal effort, you can use the contract engine for the whole lifecycle of your dApp. Starting from scratch, you can upload a smart contract, deploy new instances, initialize your application, invoke functions, or simply read values from the blockchain. It also covers some important functionalities. It can automatically identify and restore archived states, which is a very unique feature in Soroban. It can handle granular authentication for complex Soroban transactions, and it ensures that the same best practices and standards that are easy to use with Stellar Classic can be just as easy with Soroban. To support the contract engine and other functionalities, there are also special handlers built for the Horizon API and the RPC server. These allow developers to easily connect through public or private solutions, as well as to integrate with third-party services, like Validation Cloud, which is currently fully supported for Soroban transactions. There are many more unique building blocks and special features within the library for those who really want to dig deeper and build custom solutions. I'll cover those in detail for the following videos, so right now, I just want to mention one last group of features, which are the plugins. For those developers that have been in the Stellar ecosystem for a while, there are a bunch of best practices and unique features that we use from time to time in very specific situations. These could range from fee bumps, which wrap a transaction allowing for the fees to be covered by a different account, or channel accounts, which can be used to parallelize transactions at scale. The fact is that these features are important to many solutions but introduce complexity and variance to how your application handles the accounts and transactions and the signatures and many more. To remove the complexity and provide a consistent way of handling these scenarios, we developed special plugins that act as middlewares for the transaction pipelines. These plugins allow for customizations at scale or even single-use changes in how transactions are handled, making the ecosystem best practices more accessible for new and experienced developers. As I mentioned, this is just the beginning. There's much more to it that I'll be covering in the following videos. For now, I invite you all to give it a try, share your feedback, and help us continue to build this great tool for the ecosystem. See you in the next video.